Welcome to this commentary. I'm Darlanio, and this is Bishu versus Moon on the GSTL GSL Crossfire SE map. It's game one in DreamHack Summer Tournament 2011 between these two. And as we can see, they are expanding their economies. No six pool, no special, just expanding into a normal macro game so far. 9 out of 10 supplied, 10 out of 10 now for Moon. It's a bit faster for the Zerg, of course, since he has 3 larva at his expense. Okay, I'm still excited casting these games from DreamHack. It's really nice to have a Swedish tournament to comment, since I am a Swede myself. And like some of you have noted, I have an English with a Swedish accent. So now you know how to listen for that. Okay, an extractor trick was used here to get 11 drones out with 10 supply maximum. We can see that a probe from Bishu is scouting Moon's base. And Moon is sending out his overlord to scout Bishu's base. No real special things here. Spawning pool coming as normal. We have an extractor as well. And we can see Bishu messing with the drones here some. As you can see, they don't start to mine right away because he tries to mine some from the mineral fields. Haven't seen that before, and I like that idea. Maybe someone else has done that and I just haven't seen it before. Okay, we can see a gateway coming up here for Bishu, and he is planning to place a cybernetics core here. Zerg is saving up, possibly for, yes, the metabolic boost. Is he also saving for an hatchery? We don't know that yet. 20 out of 26, both players. They are neck to neck. Okay. The second assimilator is ready here and is getting saturated. Bishu wants his gas. So far, only one extractor here in the Zerg base. We have a queen spawning larva. And we have the second hatchery coming up. Bishu wasn't able to hold that off for long. But maybe this is in the wrong place. Maybe it could have become a bit more south. I'm not sure on this map. Maybe he could have placed that somewhat closer to these minerals. Not that it matters much. Two Zerglings keeping an eye on the opening, the entrance to Bishu's base, while the two other Zerglings are holding each one Selnaga tower. Expansion almost finished. We have a pylon coming up here, giving vision to Bishu. We'll see Moon's overlord perhaps. And we have a Stargate coming in for Bishu. Will there be some Void Ray or Phoenix harassment later? Maybe. Interesting. Expansion is done, and we see a queen spawning more larva here. Also some drones coming down from the main hatchery to saturate this expansion. These two Zerglings are bravely holding back the Protoss player here. This overlord moving in, wanting to see some things here maybe. And it looks like these sentries are going to take it down. Moon is not backing off. He wants to see as much as possible. He realizes this overlord will go down. And first casualty of war is an overlord. Congratulations. Okay, we have a spore crawler coming up at the natural of Moon's base. Moon that's not supply blocked anymore. Got that extra overlord out real fast. Some roaches coming here. And we have those two void rays. We saw the... Oh, they are not killing off this speedling here. We saw that Stargate earlier, and now we see those two void rays moving out. And it looks like Bishop has been able to get out from that two circling blockade. One Phoenix getting together with these two void rays, and will this natural hatch natural expansion go down? No, it won't. One spore crawler here, and two queens attacking the void rays now. One being lifted up. That was the one, the third coming out of the hatchery, but now they need to leave. One void ray being really damaged, and both having lost their shields for now. Third Phoenix coming in here. Some chat. Okay, we didn't see when that came in real time. Never mind. So three Phoenix, two void rays. Observers are going down, and one void ray being killed as well, and that was the one that wasn't so damaged before. Moon still hasn't expanded. This hatchery is healing up slowly, and the expansion is saturated. Here comes another harassment attack, lifting up drones and killing off them with the phoenixes. He's able to one-shot the drones now, since he has five phoenixes, one lifting up and four shooting. And the damage from one is 10 versus light. They can just take 40 damage, so they get killed by one blast from those four phoenixes while the fifth is holding them up. Okay, this expansion slowly getting saturated, and we have no more activity in the starport. Bishop will continue to harass with the present units, but not add any more units to this army group. The creep is spreading quite fast, and in this space we have an army not able to shoot much at the units in the sky. Only queens are able to do that, and some hydralisks coming out here, so that makes a difference. The units need to pull back, warping in more zealots here. And the Zerg has had enough. He is moving out with his units. So roaches and hydralisk coming here, as well as Zerglings, taking out that zealot at the Zelnaga Tower. The air units of the Protoss player is moving home. Zerg army is going south. Okay, it's down here. Here comes another ball of units, mostly hydralisks, some speedlings. We have a colossus in the field now. Bishop has been able to produce one colossus. These destructible rocks are being destroyed at the same time as Moon is attacking from the other side. The destructible rocks are destroyed and this Colossus tries to save itself, but it runs straight into the other ball of units. No Colossus on the board right now, and we see that the units are attacking from two sides. More units coming in here, starting to attack the natural expansion. One lazy roach over there. We see force fields going down, but they are not doing that much to this attack. Zerg units are able to attack and destroy, and this is a total disaster for Bishu. Will he be able to survive this? No, he says GG and leaves the game. He surrenders. So Moon is starting this DreamHack tournament against Bishu with 1-2-0. Moon is in the lead, and we are excited to see game 2 real soon. It will be up on YouTube in an hour or so. Thank you for watching, and until game 2, take care. Bye.